Hey everyone, and welcome to Let's Platinum and 100% Uncharted 3 Drake's Deception on the Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection, Episode 1. Alright, let's do this. Uncrushing. Quickly before I start, I'm going to say that I did try and record this already. My computer decided to freeze for no reason, and so I lost all my footage. And unfortunately, I also obtained the first treasure trophy, so when I get the first treasure, but other than that, we should be fine. Not equally. I'm actually going to mute myself here.
Those who dream by night, in the dusty recesses of their minds, wake in the day to find that it was vanity. But the dreamers of the day are dangerous men, for they may act their dream with open eyes to make it possible. This I did.
Hands up.
Enjoying yourself, pal?
Oh, yeah, you're a comedian.
Nice warm welcome.
They're both clean.
My apologies. One can't be too careful.
I'm guessing you're Talbot?
Mr. Sullivan. And Mr. Drake.
That's right.
Do you have it?
Let's,
see the money first.
Cutter.
It's all there. Now let's see it. I'll need to authenticate it.
Of course.
Silver. 16th century, Elizabethan design, inscribed with Sir Francis Drake's motto.
Well, it appears to be genuine.
Well, of course it's genuine.
If I may ask, how did you two come into this?
Does it matter?
My client will be very pleased.
Hold on a minute. Sully, this is fake.
I assure you, Mr. Drake.
Whoa, whoa, you are right. This is phony as a $3 bill. What the hell are you trying to pull here?
Perhaps I should be asking you.
This is bullshit. Deal's off, pal.
And you? You can tell your client. You blew it. Come on, Nate, let's get the hell out of here.
You're not really in a position to negotiate. Now give me the ring, take the case, and walk out of here like gentlemen. While you still can.
Do as the man says, son.
You're a thief.
Well, now, that's ironic.
Alright, we're back. Let's do this. Alright, oops. Wait, was I supposed to... No, I think I was supposed to take that punch. Alright, punch. And triangle. If I can get this right this time. Punch. Triangle. Haha, I got you this time. First time I was tried this, that guy got me. It's hard to remember about, like, what happens in this game, but I think I know what happens based on, this first, chapter. Also, when I, I attempted this before. I was talking about whether or not this, like, this would be a really good chapter to get like 10 enemies with hand-to-hand combat in a row or whatever, but there is no trophy for that in this one, so yeah, I guess it doesn't really matter. And now we get to fight some more. Interestingly, only after he throws you out this window, I think you get, chapter 1. So, that's kind of interesting. 1, 2, 3, triangle. Get off me. Hey, I was pressing triangle. Take that. Fine, come here. Take that. Haha, clever. Can you, like, let me do whatever I want to do? I did try and... It is on crushing difficulty, but... Oh, look, that famous photo of that boxer. There, that on above his head on the left. Oh, there's still quite a few enemies to take out. What am I supposed to do when that happens? Quit it. Take that. Smack, smack, smack. Oh, what? Oh, okay. That's because... Yeah, I was expecting to get that, actually. Bare-knuckle Brawler is because I took out, like, 20 enemies with melee combat. And obviously because... my recording screwed up and I had to replay. It still counted all the enemies that I took out the first time. So, if you're following along right from the beginning, you won't get that trophy there. Which is, yeah, kind of annoying because I wanted it to be proper, but... Oh well. Die, die, die. This guy is, like, basically a new enemy type, he's just like a giant. Triangle. Take that, and that, and that. So frustrating. All the stuff that I said the first time around, now I don't feel like saying. There we go. That's what I wanted. He didn't get me the first time there. Now he's gonna get taken down. See ya. Even he can't withstand that one. Alright, let's get our treasures. So, you would get the first treasure trophy here. What? Do I have to wait for it to load, or...? Oh, there. Okay, I do have to wait for it to load. That's silly. Alright, well, there's the first treasure. And normally you get the first treasure trophy after that. But because of, you know, computer issues, I don't. There's a second treasure, and that's it for this chapter, so let's just fight these guys and get out. I was gonna punch him. Alright, here we go. Cutscene time. I'll mute myself again. Be right back.
Crap.
Oh, damn it.
Come here, come here. Typical bloody Yank. All talk.
Hey, 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 hey. He's had enough, haven't you, mate?
Don't.
Stay down.
Hello, Victor.
Kate?
Still wallowing in the gutter with your protégé, I see. Not very dignified for a man of your age.
Should have known you'd be behind this. Oh, careful now. Wouldn't want you to melt.
same cocky little shit. So fearless. I wonder what you're really afraid of. Not bullets or blood or broken bones. No. You get off on all this, don't you? Cheating death? Or not?
No.
Mr. Sullivan, I won't harm your precious boy. I merely want what's mine.
Give me that back.
Cutter!
Oh, no. Oh.
Shut up!
You fool!
Oh, you're bloody welcome, Your Majesty.
Marlow, we have to get you out of here.
Oh, come on. They're a right pair of arseholes. What?
All right, well, we'll find out more about that later, I think. I'm pretty sure I know essentially what happens after that bit, but for now, let's go 20 years into the past and play what I consider to be quite an inspired idea as young Drake. I think it was really clever to kind of give him like a little bit more of a backstory. You know, once a thief, always a thief. 20 years earlier, putting Drake around, say, 34, 35. Here he's sort of depicted as about a 14, 15-year-old. Interesting to note that he's dressed in a shirt that was originally intended to be his, like, normal shirt at the beginning of in Uncharted 1. But they, yeah, they decided against it eventually. Greatness from Small Beginnings. Alright, first treasure, right here. Greatness from Small Beginnings is the motto of Francis Drake. And on the, what's it called? On the ring that he has is, it says Sic Parvis Magna. There's another treasure there. And that is the motto.
Maybe upstairs.
Latin. Sic Parvis Magna. Oh, his feet actually connect properly with the stairs. Oh, not so much there, yep, but no. It was doing pretty well. Alright, so collect those two treasures and go upstairs. You know, it feels like the beginning of a speedrun because I know exactly what to do. Walk over to this case and press up. Okay, now let's wait for this cutscene to play out. Yeah, so he's apparently looking for the ring here already. And there's Sully. This bit I don't remember. I don't really understand it yet. We'll find out later, I guess. Jeez, even back then Sully was huge. Look how swole he is. So swole. Let go of me. Alright, now we get thrown out of the museum. You can see Sully there.
Pendejo.
I think pendejo means, like bastard or prick or something like that. Alright, let's follow Sully, and we're gonna grab some treasures on the way. Jesus, and it's so much quicker because I know, because I've done this bit. I was so close to finishing the episode as well, that was the annoying bit. So there's a treasure there. There's Sully there. The next one is still a little while away, but for the time being, we have to follow Sully. Go next to this police car, and then it'll tell you to take cover, and sort of teaching you the basics again. Press square to move quickly. Did I say square? Circle. Press circle to move quickly. And then when you're in the corner, press forward and circle. You can make it past that bit. And now wait here.
Don't mind if I do.
Reminds me of like Aladdin. But it's rotten.
It was rotten anyway.
Okay, let's keep following Sully.
Now where did he go?
Basically can't press any other button. Just walk. Alright, so the next treasure is over here to the right. He got stuck there a little bit. He doesn't turn around, so you don't have to worry about that.
Where is he going?
I wonder what would happen if I went up there. It's right here, sitting on that little ledge there. Oh, he went there. Okay. That's good to know. I'm going to follow him in a sec, but I got to go this way to get a treasure. I actually went over there before, but that might have been the wrong way. So here's the next one. To give you an idea, my computer froze when I walked over there. So I was, you know, we're like, what, 16 minutes in? I only had to film probably like 5 more minutes at that time to finish the episode, but nope. Game decided, or computer decided, yeah, I'm not going to get anything. Okay. I wish I knew why, but I don't. Alright, let's keep following him. The next treasure isn't for a little while. We have to do some climbing, apparently.
What's he doing?
Actually, I think it is in this bit here. Yeah, let's follow him over here. Oh, he technically should have seen me there.
Damn. It's locked.
Alright, let's...
gonna have to find another way.
Let's climb, then. Let's see. Do I remember this? I think it's here. Yeah, that's it. And then up on that aircon vent, if I can reach it, there we go. And then, hang on. Left, up, and then we climb over here. This is really cool.
What's he doing?
I love the way they designed this. Come on. Okay. And then over here. Oops. Hang on, I think I might need to do that.
Aquí lo tiene.
That's a ticket. Adios, amigo.
Okay, I gotta get that wallet. Crap. I can't go down that
way. Alright. That's what a friend of mine was talking about in one of the comments for my first Uncharted video. But I don't know why he mentioned it then. If it only happens now. Alright, where is the treasure? It's somewhere... here we go. There's the treasure. Alright, brilliant. Now, I guess I jump off this. Up to that. I gotta look at where the next one is though. Over here. Okay, I'm going to try and do this at the same time. And then... what? I bet I can spot him from the roof. Alright, so let's jump over here. Oh, lucky I looked it up, because apparently it's near here. He climbs so strangely. Okay, jump to this sign, and go on the O here. And it's hidden inside the O. Okay, now... now I got to go down. Oh, is he with... Kate? I didn't even realize that. Hang on a sec. Yeah, he's up there.
Don't wanna lose him.
Hang on. Where is he? Yeah, there. There's no more treasures for this chapter.
Damn it. Don't wanna go down there.
But, let's see.
I gotta find a way to get that wallet. Okay, it's right there in his pocket. Now's my chance.
Okay, careful. Let's try it. Simple as that.
Swear to me, viejo.
Let's try that.
Let go of me, old man.
Let go of me.
Ah, that's what I thought. Now don't try to run. You're a long way from home, son.
Don't call me that.
Parents must be worried about you.
Yeah, not likely.
Okay, sore subject. That was a nice lift back there. You're pretty good.
I don't know what you're talking about, old man.
Hey, don't call me that. Your technique is really sloppy, though. You're telegraphing all your moves.
You're crazy.
Yeah? You've been tailing me all over town. Probably figured me for an easy mark. But you picked the wrong guy, pal.
What?
My wallet. Fine. Maybe we'll just call the police.
Go ahead. Of course, they might wonder why a middle-aged tourist is following young boys down alleys.
You are a crafty little beggar, aren't you?
I know how to take care of myself. Anyway, I'm pretty sure you don't like the cops any more than I do.
Good point.
So, I'll just be taking your wallet?
The wallet.
Had to try.
Of course you did.
And for some reason, Sully doesn't look at it to make sure that nothing's gone. A bit confusing, but I will.
Telegraphing all my moves, huh?
All right, let's get in there.
All right, museum's closed.
Chapter 3. Okay, so the next treasure is, I believe it's on the way. I can't go any faster. I believe it's on the way to this next bit. So I'm going to try and get there. Let's climb up. I think it's actually there. You might be able to see it flashing. Hang on. Just to the right of the middle of the screen, just in front of Drake's face there, his nose. So I'm gonna try and get there. I think I have to climb here, don't I? Yeah, that's right. It doesn't look like you're gonna reach that, but you can. So you climb up here. Let's go over here. And then you gotta do a lot of running.
There it is.
And jumping. Huh. And he just makes it.
Oh, that was close.
And because he's a boy and not a man, that didn't break. So, that's how you get in there, but before you do... God, this would be so... Some of these are really tough to find. Did the internet exist in 2011? Or at least, did it... Yeah. 4 years ago, but there weren't, like, the quality videos that we have nowadays, I don't think. Probably had to use GameFAQs. Who remembers that? Who remembers using GameFAQs for like text walkthroughs where you'd have to control F your way to finding out what you wanted? Okay. Oh, did I just find another one just by accident? I did. Yoink. Alright, so that's the next treasure. That's great. Now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna quickly... Oh. Oh, okay, you can enter this area more than one way. You can apparently also open this door, but only from the other side. Alright, so that's that next treasure, and the next one is still in this room, right here apparently, although, oh, right, next to that thing. Awesome. Okay, and now we are done with all the treasures for this chapter, so let's work out, alright, we have to get the, which side is it on? Oh, it doesn't matter. There we go, we have to get the ring. I'm like, why are we here? Okay, we'll sit through this cutscene and then we should be good to finish the episode. doesn't make any sense. Sully opened the case. I assume he opened the case when we first saw him use the key. So why would Drake need the key again to open the case again? Wouldn't it be opened? And if it was opened, wouldn't it be closed? I mean, wouldn't he have closed it?
Whoa.
Damn it, kid.
My victim, look who it is. The filthy little stray that made off with your wallet.
Come on, son. You haven't got a chance. Just hand it over.
Now, the ring.
What ring?
Catherine!
Who do you think you are, boy? You're nothing but a filthy, cast-off little beggar. You're not fit to touch these objects.
What the hell do you think you're doing? He's just a kid.
Stop him!
Alright, run like hell.
Holy crap.
Alright, wait. How much time do I have left? Oh yeah, I can do this. Just a chase scene. Oh. No, no! Ah, they got me. What a perfect, little section that was. It's like, it looks like, oh, okay, just jump up to the top window, but we're not adult Drake, so we have to use something to kind of, help us out. Really, really clever. Good level design. Well done, Naughty Dog. Like as if you guys need more praise. Squeeze! That square button just, like, flashed really a lot. Really a lot. Alright, where do I go? Yeah, this bit's tricky. Ah, okay. I was like, how do I know where to go? And I just have to make sure that I look at... He would have been dead for sure. Broken his legs. Never to walk again. Yeah, just gotta make sure I look at where these guys are coming from and avoid them at all costs. Not in that door. Over here. Over here. Over there. Up here. Run, run, run. Did you just shoot me? I think I have to do this, right? And there's a mini cutscene, or no? No, no mini cutscene. Whoa. And jump. And jump. Make sure they all break. For good effect. Here, here. Up here. Stay on the rooftops. Drop, then. Oh, X. Thanks, Sully. Crap, don't fall. Damn it. You might catch me this time. Okay, up here. I'm sure we're almost at the end. Big jump. That one, you can definitely tell it's a cutscene. Hey, you broke it anyway. And help. Definitely smashed your head into it. Wow. All this is very unrealistic.
We got him.
Whoa. Whoa.
Excuse me. Coming through.
Coming through.
Sorry about that.
Wow, look at these houses. This reminds me of one of the Assassin's Creed games where you could like run through a house to try and get away. Go, 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 go. Come on. I've been going for a while. Oh, it's gonna break. Oh, it's gonna break for that guy. Sucked in. Stop shooting at me. Just a kid. Oh, what? Why did I die? I wasn't supposed to jump that way? Let's try that again. And of course it's one of those ridiculous things where you do exactly what you need to do but the game doesn't respond in the way that it should. Alright, cool. Made it. Watch this last cutscene and we'll call it a day. Oops, I killed you.
Look what we have here.
Agent Smith.
Whoops. You all right? What are you shaking for? Just close your eyes. This won't hurt a bit. Oh.
You're okay, kid.
What do you mean, exactly? I'm like... kind of... like I'm okay, or... I'm like real good.
You can relax, kid. We're safe here. Go on. Suit yourself. We don't want it.
Yoink.
What do you want from me?
What do you want from me?
A little gratitude would be nice. I did just save your ass back there.
Thanks. But what's in it for you? I mean, you're a crook, right? You gotta have an angle.
You are one piece of work, kid. What's your story, anyway?
Look, mister. No offense, but I don't even know you.
Easily remedied. Victor Sullivan. This would be the part where you introduce yourself. Okay. Suppose you tell me what's so special about that ring.
It belongs in my family. I'm just taking it back.
Passed down from Francis Drake himself.
That's right.
I don't know how to break this to you, kid, but Drake didn't have any heirs. No children.
Well, not with his wife back in England, anyway.
Okay, good point. Let me see it. Come on, kid. If I was gonna take it from you, I would have done it by now. Thank you. So, what is this? Parvis Mem...
Sic Parvis Magna. It means greatness from small beginnings. That was his motto.
Yeah?
What's a motto you?
Queen Elizabeth gave it to him in 1581, when he got back to England after circumnavigating the globe. That's when she made him a knight.
Well, you sure as hell didn't learn that on the streets. As a kid your age, no Latin.
The nuns sort of insisted on it.
So, like a boarding school?
It's a nice word for it.
Okay, then. So what was all that business with the ring and that astrolabe thing back there?
Why don't you tell me? You're the one working for him.
Look, kid. A client wants something, I obtain it. For a price. I don't ask any questions. It's just a job.
Look pretty friendly to me.
Yeah, well... anyway. I'm pretty sure I'm fired.
Okay, look. First of all, that was no astrolabe. It's some sort of decoding device. Check this out. On his way around the world, Drake sailed through the East Indies. Only he says that it took him 6 months to get from here to here.
Yeah, so?
So it doesn't add up. He was way too good a sailor for that. It would have taken him a month. Tops. He was hiding something. Something big.
How big?
Like secret mission from the Queen big. Like millions in plundered treasure that hasn't ever been recovered big.
That big?
That big.
And that decoder has something to do with it.
I would bet my life on it.
Oh, swell. And Marlowe's got it.
Won't do her much good without the key.
So it's a stalemate, then?
For now.
So you still haven't told me what your name is?
And you still haven't told me what you want from me.
Okay. Look, you got talent, but you got a lot to learn. You stick with me, and I'll teach you a few things.
Thanks. But I'm doing just fine on my own.
Yeah, clearly. What do you say we try this again? My friends call me Sully.
Nathan Drake. Nate.
Drake, huh? Okay. I see great things in our future, kid. Great things.
That was a good scene. Alright, I'm gonna have to wait for this as well.
They're gone.
Perfect.
Alright, lads?
Bet you were gonna put a silencer on that thing.
Sally, you've got no sense of drama.
Right. All that racket's gonna bring the cops any minute. Let's get the hell out of here.
Could have pulled a couple of those punches, Charlie.
What do you mean? I hardly touched you.
You headbutted me.
All right. I got a little swept up in the moment.
You were the one who said make it look realistic.
Better stay on this good side.
All right, Broad Ice, look sharp. They're coming your way. Don't lose them.
Told you they'd take the bait.
How long do you reckon before they realize this is a fake?
Who cares? Finally flushed them out.
Now we just follow them back to their hole.
You do realize you make everything...
Do?
Oh, gosh.
Let's get moving.
All right. Finally, a place to stop. Alright guys, I want to thank you for watching episode 1 of Let's Platinum and 100% Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception on the Uncharted Nathan Drake Collection. My name is Ultimate456 and I'll see you next time.